Back up a little bit, back up a little bit.
That looks good.
All right, let's go.
Woo, come on.
What's your tagline?
They didn't want a tagline, they want to hook it up.
So how are they gonna hook up a thing out in the middle of the water?
I don't know.
Oh,
I want it right there against that wall.
Copy that.
I'm a little nervous, I ain't gonna lie.
Paul, I need you to back over here now. Now, go over here. Paul!
Come on, I got it. I got it.
What the happened? I missed my clip. Tighten up, tighten up. Go, go, go.
No, 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 no. No, no, no. No, no, no. Oh, God.
Hold on. The inspector's here.
Not long enough.
Well, Fred's got his ideas and I've got mine. When it comes down to it, I'm in charge.
Oh, what the hell's that?
That's the bear.
What the f***?
Get back! Get out of here!
That's a wild man.
And you thought your job was hard!
Extreme dredging, brother. Extreme dredging.
Whoa. The eagle has landed.
Go.
I've seen gold 15 feet down in that hole. We're gonna get it this year.
This thing eats, man. Eat, baby. Come on. Woo!
That's gold.
That's gold.
All right, I'm getting ready to do this death-defying act out here.
It's only a 250-foot straight down fall.
First time across this year? Great, man. Whew! I can't wait to get out there and get some gold. That's what it's all about. Let's go. Wow, what a sight. Boy, it is beautiful. Let's go get some gold!
Be safe, Fred.
The Dakota boys, Fred and Dustin Hurt, are back in Alaska.
Time to get some gold!
Risking their lives on the hunt for gold in the raging waters of McKinley Creek, one of the world's most dangerous mine sites.
I'd love to pull up about a bucket of gold. Just a big, big bucket of gold. That would make my year. That would make my 10 years.
5,000 feet up in the Chilkat Mountains, a series of glaciers eroded gold from the motherlode over millions of years. Meltwater carried it downstream and deposited pockets of gold in the bends and plunge pools of these remote, rugged creeks. 100 years ago, old-timers hauled nearly 80,000 ounces of gold from these creeks, worth today almost $100 million.
The old-time miners couldn't get to where I'm digging now. It's just too damn hard. This year, I've got more equipment and more people. We're definitely gonna get down to the jackpot.
We're the only rednecks crazy enough to do this. We're back again.
Woo-hoo!
Wes Richardson and his brother, Paul, have returned from Texas for their share of the McKinley fortune.
You know, we're all a bit crazy, and we've got that fever.
I'm ready to find the gold. It's time to get the gold.
It's rock and roll, brother.
Oh, yeah.
Woo-hoo! Back to work!
Ex-U.S. Marine and diver Carlos Minor.
Morning commute, man. Woo!
Has even more at stake this season.
I just had a kid. Just had a little girl. The deal was with my wife was for me to come up in the first season, we can have a kid, and we'll get a church wedding. So one down. If we find gold, church wedding. Everybody's invited.
All right. You ready?
See you on the other side.
Here we go.
Here comes our new guy, Rich. He's in from Oregon.
Don't look down.
He runs a computer business, but he is really handy with a wrench.
Oh, my God. What am I doing?
I need that. He's left his family.
It was crazy. I'm scared to death when I took off, and I'm shaking right now. Oh, my God. That was crazy.
Now the real work starts. Now we still got to hike to the dang mine site.
Come on, guys. I know there's gold on my claim. I'm going to get it this season.
All right, guys. Ready, watch out.
To get to the mine site, they have a mile and a half hike through remote Alaskan wilderness.
I know I hear something come from up that way.
Bear! Bear! There's
hey, bear!
Bear!
Right there!
Yeah, hell yeah!
Get out of here!
Bear!
Yeah!
He's all right. He's gone.
Bro, that was close.
You know they're hungry right now.
Yeah. Really hungry.
Here we go.
The next challenge. A 300-foot descent to the raging creek below.
Rich, I know you knew, so just don't die, all right? This is dangerous stuff here.
Gotcha.
And if you knock a rock loose, yell rock.
Okay.
Rocks! Rocks!
These treacherous ravines are the reason no one has yet mined the gold from Dustin's claim.
Whoa!
Oh!
Whoa.
Oh! Fred! Fred!
I'm all right.
Holy moly, that was close.
Hell, this is where I wanted to go in the first place.
Watching Fred walk this hill, he's almost 75 now, and just starting to wonder how long he can do this stuff. So hopefully this year is our year to hit it big. I'm $75,000 in debt, and if I don't get down to the gold, I'm screwed.
The sooner we can get started, the better.
Holy shit. Bridge is down. Oh, that don't look good.
What the hell? Ah, it split in half, man.
Yeah.
We got our bridge.
Well, we got a little bump in the road, but hell, that ain't gonna stop us. That is nothing. It lost a few boards, but we could probably bolt that thing all the way through. This is gonna be a bunch of work, but we can do it. And we're gonna get down and get the gold.
Amen, brother.
Right on.
Amen.
Yep.
Last season, how much gold did you guys get?
Well, we got a couple ounces.
I mean, why would you want to come back to this place? I'm in the exact same spot. And you've got very little gold.
We're here because we know there's gold down there. I've seen gold 15 feet down in that hole, right underneath that bridge, and a little bit back. As soon as we got to the bottom of this hole, we started finding gold immediately. Like it just started happening, just immediately.
Last season.
Look at that right there.
After 20 weeks of dredging.
Wow.
The Dakota boys hit a pay streak that produced half their season total in just 2 days.
That's incredible.
Clean that sucker out.
But just as they started to hit this major deposit.
Get him out of there!
Woo! Doggy! Look at that mother.
A ferocious storm.
That bridge is gonna go.
Get out, get out.
Forced them to leave behind a treasure chest.
Watch out.
That could contain millions in gold.
Gold is in that hole. And I'm gonna tell you what, we're gonna get it this year.
You gotta have trust in us, man.
It's there.
We've done the testing.
It's there, man.
Mother Nature kicked our ass last season, but not this season.
That's my daughter's freaking college education right there. That's my new home. I'm itching to get in this dang water.
To dive in this water, you definitely gotta be a little bit of crazy, a lot of guts, and some big brass balls.
I think we ought to get on it. Woo! I'm gonna hit 75 this summer. This is going to be my summer. We're gonna get some gold.
Up ahead.
Welcome to the death zone.
Yeah, dude.
The hardest part is this water wants to eat us.
I see a helicopter.
Here we go.
No, no! Oh!
Pull the rock, man.
It ain't long enough.
Hey,
not long enough! Oh!
We gotta figure out how to get across there. That's the biggest problem.
High in the Chilcat Mountains, the Dakota boys return to their mine site.
Make a workstation off of that. Yeah, it looks pretty dangerous to me.
They can't dive for gold until they repair the winter storm damage.
To fix this bridge, I need to get the line across where it hangs down and we can work off of that and jack up that other side.
We're gonna use this line as a frickin' anchor.
To pick up on it with coming logs and then bolt it together.
Dustin's plan, use the existing cable across the creek to attach a line to a ratchet, then hoist the bridge up so it's level. Next, pull the short, broken end of the beam back into place and secure the repair with four wooden braces.
Welcome to the death zone.
This is very extreme. Whew. Take your time, brother. All right.
Ugliest knot I ever did tie.
Well, I set my line, and I think I'm ziplining back down.
Ah, frickin' amazing, man.
To attach Dustin's rope, someone needs to cross the broken bridge. Paul is first to volunteer.
Paul!
No mistakes. If you fall in that water, you're f***ed, man.
Uh-oh. I lost one.
That current ain't no joke. It'll spin around and just bite the out of you.
Woo! Made it to the other side! Hell yeah, you did it, brother!
This is you?
Yeah.
Right here, right?
Yeah, yeah.
All right.
Next, Carlos must attach the ratchet line to the bridge. Just inches above the deadly 38-degree meltwater.
Do you see what's below me? And I'm right in the middle, brother. Look at me f***ing ready to die.
That's a really bad spot to fall. So don't fall. Lift up on that thing. Can you lift on it?
It's down to Carlos to maneuver the 300-pound broken section of beam back into place.
Papa! Son of a river, man. Oh! Whoa! Oh, oh, don't right, with us. I got you. Hey, hold on. Pull it. I'm caught.
Got you?
Yeah.
I'm getting the pinch point. Get out of there. Get out of there.
Got it.
Thank you. All right, hold on. That was bad. Let's not do that again. The hardest part is this water wants to eat us. Guys, we gotta fix this bridge.
Come on, guys. Come on, man, you got it.
Now we might be able to lift that up.
Here we go, man. Coming up.
Yeah, this is gonna work. All right, I need this board to be jacked up when I lift this.
Okay. Come on, guys. Come on, man, you got it.
That's it.
That's it, man.
That's the right.
Why don't we put a tourniquet on it? Got it.
Carlos ties a rope tourniquet to pull the two parts of the beam together.
What are you gonna twist that with?
A pipe or something. Yeah, dude. That'll hold it.
I'm gonna brace it up with some boards. I'm gonna put some boards on the inside and the outside.
That should be it, huh?
I think that'll do us.
Ah!
Few more boards, we'll be done.
That's it!
All right, well, we got it done. Good job, guys.
Hell yeah.
We put it right back together. Bubble gum and duct tape, but it's together and it's crossable, so that's a bridge.
I mean, the real world, this is a piece of trash. But this is beautiful here, man.
Next day, down at their base camp on Porcupine Creek.
So we'll duct tape it.
All right, that sounds
good. And it'll get us by.
Fred and new guy Rich are reassembling the dredge they used last season.
This is the old dredge that we were using. Nice and compact. Basically, all this thing is a giant water vacuum cleaner.
This season, Dustin has a secret weapon.
Oh, get out of town, dude.
A brand new $17,000 dredge, capable of processing 12 yards of pay dirt an hour, twice as much as Fred's old one.
This frickin' sluice is frickin' huge, man. From point A to point B, it has its own zip code. No gold is ever gonna escape this.
No.
How much dirt are we gonna move with
this? I'm hoping at least twice as much. The dredge is, it's beautiful. It's about three times the size, surface size. This fixes all our problems.
What the hell you got over here anyway?
A giant-sized dredge.
Yeah, stab that right in.
Our sluice box is just about the same size as your full dredge.
Bigger isn't necessarily better.
Fred won't admit it, but he wants to work off of this machine. He's looking at his little bitty toy over there, and he's feeling a little inadequate. And we're ready to go. It's gonna make me some gold now. All we gotta do is get it up there and get started.
With two dredges this season, father and son will be working together, side by side.
These are Dustin's claims. Technically, I'm working for him. But basically, maybe I'll be an old sage and advisor or something of that nature.
Got a little bit of lumber coming. Eventually, we're gonna need it.
Fred, that's not just a little bit of lumber, man. We already talked about this, that I didn't want you building a whole bunch of stuff. I don't understand.
I just said.
No, I'm not.
So if you need pieces of lumber, how are you going to get them out there?
What do I need carry lumber them? For, Fred?
There's nothing on the other side of the creek to even walk on. Everything
we're not,
is
we're not building
like this.
This year. We're not building.
How about if I just leave all of that sitting right there, and you pay the helicopter bill when we have to have it out there? Watch yourself down there. Well, I'm just planning ahead.
Fred's gonna deck the entire creek if I let him. And we're not building a whole bunch of stuff. It's not happening this year. And we've had these discussions, and he decided he was gonna go ahead and buy the lumber anyway.
Okay, thank you very much.
He's got no rights to do any of this stuff.
Sir, you too.
He don't own anything. His name is on nothing. Just somehow he thinks he's in charge. And this is where we get into trouble. But I'm in control. It's not going up there. So today, we've got a helicopter coming, so we can, we're gonna lift all of our stuff into the dive site. I spent every dime I could on this stuff, and I'm just worried that the helicopter lift may go wrong, and my dredge might get destroyed. And that'll be the end of everything here, because I can't buy another one. I just need it to go okay. Who knows? Hopefully Fred doesn't mess this up for me.
I'll tape these things off so they don't get hung up on anything.
We would be in some serious trouble if we smashed this.
Better not smash it. This is our
$17,000 dredge.
You drop this thing out of the sky, we're just going home.
Oh, Lord, big day. We got helicopter flights today. We've got probably about a half a dozen or so loads to haul out of here. We got two dredges. We got fuel to take out there. We have baskets. We have material.
Wes, don't let him bring up that lumber, man. We don't need it up there. Please.
Okay.
Lumber needs to stay down here. We don't have any space for it up there.
All right. See y'all in a few.
Dustin, Carlos, and Paul head to the dive site, leaving Fred in charge of loading.
It's Mary. How you doing?
How's it going? Long time no see.
That's it. It's been about a year or two, or
yeah,
at
really,
least since
no
the
kidding.
Last time here. We have probably a half a dozen different things.
Okay.
We got that dredge.
Okay.
We have a big one over here.
Oh, okay.
That particular unit is going to land in the water,
mm-hmm.
and Dustin will direct you where he wants to land that thing.
You guys have taglines on that, so the guys
There's
can...
There's going to be a tagline on it to grab it.
Yep.
Yes.
Yep.
You have nets?
I do have nets. I brought two nets.
Two nets. Great.
I like slinging because I like the challenge, but it does require practice and patience.
Good, good, good. There's our first lift. There you go.
All right.
Clear. Woo-wee. Good, smooth lift.
That is badass.
The only way to get equipment to the remote mine site is a 2-mile flight through narrow mountain canyons.
Here we go.
Things are getting real, brother.
Dustin, I got one more net load first, and then the dredges.
Copy that.
On the way. Over there, over there.
Yeah!
Watch yourself.
I got it.
Yep.
That went beautifully.
That was a good lift.
That was perfect.
Just about everything's here. Now it's time to get the dredges.
All righty there, Mary. Little dredge next.
Copy that.
Next up, Fred's lightweight dredge.
Yeah, go, baby, go!
Fly, baby, fly! Woo! Right now, of course, the dredges are our most important items.
Here she comes!
All right, go, 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 go!
The tagline on the dredge allows Dustin to guide it into the landing zone.
And I'm gonna try to put it right there. So you, a little slack.
Perfect!
The Eagle has landed.
Yes.
That's perfect, man. All right, guys, pucker time!
Big dredge next!
Back up a little bit, back up a little bit. Move it forward, move it forward.
Dustin's new dredge weighs 1,800 pounds.
Loosen it up.
He has no choice but to land it directly in the raging water of the creek because it is too heavy to lift by hand.
Ideally, I want it right there against that wall. I'm a little nervous, I ain't gonna lie.
Yep, that looks good.
All right, let's go.
Woo, come on.
Where's your tagline?
They didn't want a tagline, they want to hook it up. I wanted to put a tagline.
Where the hell is the tagline?
They didn't want me to put a tagline.
Oh, that's the wrong thing to do.
They got some kind of their own plan.
So how are they going to hook up a thing out in the middle of the water?
I don't know. I think they had planned to have their ropes tied off on the sides, and as soon as it set down, they were going to go over there and just clip it with carabiners.
Well, that's the wrong thing to do. That's the wrong thing to do.
Yeah, Mary, I'm going to ask you to do something a little different than we planned. I'm standing over on land with two lines, and I'm going to hook into it upstream across the creek.
Copy that. I will hold it while you attack the line, and then set it upstream from you?
That's correct.
When the dredge arrives, Dustin will attach two taglines. The lines are anchored to pulleys, on opposite sides of the creek to prevent the raging current from ripping the $17,000 dredge downstream.
We've never landed a dredge in the water out there before. There's all kinds of things that can go wrong.
Paul, I need you to back over here now. Now, go over here.
Paul and Carlos stand by with the anchors. Dustin's challenge, clip both lines onto the hovering dredge. Dustin Hurt's brand new $17,000 dredge is hanging dangerously above the raging waters of McKinley Creek.
Paul!
Come on, I got it!
What the happened? I missed my clip. Tighten up! Go!
No!
Okay, thank you. Drop it, please.
Copy that.
That was absolutely perfect. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah!
What a rush!
So did you see what happened? When I clipped, it missed and went into the water. And I was like, oh no, there's only one rope on this thing. And I've lost my frickin' mind. $17,000 is gonna wash down the damn creek. Oh my God, Paul. Had to take up all the slack. Otherwise, the dredge would have taken off because I missed that little thing. Oh my God, what a stressful situation.
Hang on.
Got another load.
What is it?
See it, Paul?
He sent that lumber.
Lumber, brother. Wood, man.
Damn it. Frank got his damn way.
Leave it to Fred, brother. Leave it to Fred.
Unbelievable.
That's funny, man.
Dustin.
Did you get my special delivery up there?
Yeah, we dropped it in the river. It should be about 2 right now if you go check out
45-3.
Next day, the Dakota boys return to the mine site to prepare for their first dive.
Things are coming together right now. Got a dredge in the water. I want to dive, dude. Dang, I can't wait to get back in the water. I'm serious.
Look at this, huh? Look at it.
Yep. It's never been this clear.
That is the best that's ever gonna look, right there. Make no mistake, I am in a hurry. But that is the one rock I think that is dangerous. Gotta move the death rock before we get in the water. We're gonna put this winch up here, because we're gonna move a rock. Hold on.
All right, just
hold on.
Killer rock down there, the second one from the wall. If the current comes up while you're down in the hole and we leave it there and it moves just a little bit and decides to just roll into the hole where you're at, you're dead. You'll never know you were dead.
Dustin's plan. Drill anchor bolts into the 3-ton boulder and attach a line so they can winch the killer rock safely out of their dive site.
Freaking amazing, man.
Woo-hoo! And you thought your job was hard.
Who thinks about doing stupid stuff like this? Nobody thinks about stupid stuff like this.
Let's go.
Ready?
Yeah. Pull the rock, man.
Let me look at it before you pull it.
Hold on.
Wait a minute, hold on.
The inspector's here.
Damn right.
All I could see was somebody driving a bolt 2 inches into the rock.
It ain't long enough.
Hey, just smile and say, hey, look how good that looks.
Not long enough. Not long enough. That long.
Doesn't matter. We've done this before.
I just saw him put in a short anchor bolt there, but what we really need is about a 12-inch long anchor instead of about a couple of 8-inch ones. Makes a big difference on the strength of those bolts.
Well, Fred's got his ideas and I've got mine. When it comes down to it, I'm in charge.
You gonna pull it?
Go.
Come on, baby, you can do it.
Come on, roll.
Yeah, look, it's gonna spin.
Roll. Did it move?
Yeah.
Hell yeah.
Keep going.
Come on, a little bit more. What broke?
Oh, the anchor bolt busted.
It came out, huh?
Yep.
Just pull the damn thing out of the rock. Hollered at them earlier, but there again, the young ones don't listen.
Check it out, man. Those are the bolts that blew out, man.
Oh, good.
Yeah. I've used that before, and it's been just fine, but now it's time to step it up. Look what I got now. This is the biggest ones we can use for this situation, so. Yeah. It's no comparison.
Man, if we blow those out, we're in serious trouble.
Round two. This is literally man against rock. We're going to war with each other.
Holy is it cold.
Thank you, amigo.
Yes, sir.
Do you feel comfortable putting the chain on?
Yes, sir.
And go.
A week ago, new guy Rich was reformatting hard drives at his computer store in Oregon.
Here.
Hey, Fred.
You're putting an inexperienced guy out there. You're with danger.
Sink or swim, Fred. Sink or swim, literally.
That's bull.
He's a grown-ass man. Treat him like one. See what I have to deal with every day.
Put it right in the middle. Put in the middle if you can. Yeah, slide your hook in the middle. There you go. Yeah. All right, come on out of there. Excellent job,
yeah.
Rich. Excellent job. Look like they got this thing set up the right way. Oh, yeah, you got it.
Oh, good. We got Fred's okay. We can now go on with our lives. Fred has given us the okay.
All right, pull it.
Come on, man. Keep winching that thing. If it'll go,
come on, boom!
That is a big son of a.
That is a big rock.
I want it to roll.
See what you got.
Make it scream, brother. Make it scream.
Come on, man. A little bit more.
Come on, man. You got it, Paul.
There it goes.
Well, it's out.
Yeah.
It's out.
Good job.
No matter what.
Time to dive, guys.
Hey, Rich, I need a military guy. You know how to fold a flag?
It's been a long time, about 18 years.
Let's see if I can remember how to do this. It's been about 40 years since I folded a flag. I remember a military detail when my father got killed. My dad, who was ex-Marine and ex-Navy. He did both services. He got killed in 1958. Well, I was only about 13, 14 years old. And I remember them folding that flag and handing it to my mother. You gotta be proud of your flag, man.
Absolutely, I'd die for it.
I think it's close. Especially for a couple of novices.
He did.
Amen.
Hey,
today we are going diving. I'm going diving. I know the water is a little out of control today.
Danger, boss.
It is dangerous.
I've done it before, so we're doing it again. If something should happen, I accept the responsibility of that. So there we go. Paul, you're gonna be on comms.
All right.
Carlos,
gotcha.
You're gonna get my tagline. All right, get her done.
Get her done.
I just want to get this damn water and find my gold. I want my pockets full of gold right now.
It's been a long time since I've ever seen anything like this.
It's brutal.
There's absolutely no way we'd be diving in any of this stuff. Totally out of control.
500 tons of ice-cold glacial meltwater pour through McKinley Creek every minute.
All right, I'm going in. I gotta put on my super suit.
Dustin?
Yeah?
I really don't think y'all be getting in there right now.
But where you wanna dive, no deal.
I'm just tired of building and fixing and rigging stuff. I just wanna dredge.
That current is gonna be vicious right there.
Let me get under the surface. It'll be fine. Start slow.
He ain't gonna listen. He ain't gonna listen.
He dead set on going in there. Impatience is you. I'm a little nervous. The water's a little faster than I like it to be, but I think I can still handle it. It's time to dredge and go get the damn gold.
I kind of think that Dustin is kind of jumping a little bit too much right now. But that's what gold does for you, brother. That's what gold does.
Paul, you there?
Yep, I got you.
Carlos, you got me?
I got you, Dustin.
Everybody good?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going in.
Dustin's new dredge is a floating wash plant. The suction hose draws gold-bearing dirt up to the onboard sluice, which catches the heavy gold in its riffles. It is also his life support system, providing an air supply, hot water to his dive suit, and a safety line to haul him out in case of emergency.
I see rocks coming over the box. Oh, this is a nice dredge, man. I love it.
This is amazing, dude.
In my opinion, it's just unnecessary to be getting out in that type of water. A little bit of that father instinct to keep your kid safe.
Oh, this thing eats, man. Eat, baby. Come on.
Yeah. Woo! Hell yeah.
Copy that. Number one, going upstream to give it a good checkout.
Now we're going full.
Got it.
Current's
got me a little bit.
Oh, no.
Get me out of here.
Ah. Oh,
right.
Getting up in there into that current was not the right thing to do.
Well, there was a point where I lifted my head just a little bit of head lift, and that current just whipped me back, and I started flipping.
Dustin, Fred! There's a little flake of gold in there. There's two pieces of gold in there that you can see.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
There's quite a bit of gold right there, actually.
I love it.
They got gold, Fred.
I gotta see it to believe it.
The
The sluice box is full of little bits of gold. It's incredible.
That's gold.
That's gold! If Fred's in this gold, that's gold.
That's our first gold of the season.
That's awesome, man. I'm next. I'm next.
The current got him, but damned if he didn't find some gold along with it.
You, man, I want to dive, dude. I'm next, man.
This is going to have everybody ready to get in the water.
We're going to do good this year.
This season on Gold Rush, Whitewater.
This is the real deal. This is dangerous. And this is a lot of work.
Oh, crazy is you.
We're going to kick a little ass.
We just found a nugget inside of the wall.
Are you
kidding? I am not kidding.
We're on the gold already. It's only going to get better from here.
Yeah! Like the water is killer.
No air in this mask. Where is everybody?
Sick and tired of bull.
I know a lot of divers have been killed 15, 10 feet of water because they got too complacent.
Oh, yeah.
If you guys can pump up the hot water a little bit for me, please.
I'm gonna rev up the engines.